Okay, so hello everyone. My name is Prashant Agrawal and I'm working as an analytics specialist solution architect in AWS, where I primarily focus on Amazon OpenSearch service. And today I will be talking about managing time series data with data streams using Amazon OpenSearch service. So before getting into the data streams, let me explain about Amazon OpenSearch service. So Amazon OpenSearch service is a fully managed service that makes it easy to deploy, operate, and scale OpenSearch along with legacy Elasticsearch cluster in AWS cloud. It also has tight integration with other AWS services such as Amazon Kinesis Data Firehose, AWS Lambda, CloudWatch, and so on. So let's take a quick detour and talk about what is OpenSearch. So OpenSearch is a community-driven open source search and analytics suite, which is derived from Apache 2.0 licensed version of Elasticsearch 7.10.2 and Kibana 7.10.2 projects. It consists of a search engine, which is OpenSearch, that provides you a way to perform search on your data, as well as a way to analyze your logs using visualization interface called OpenSearch dashboards. So using OpenSearch, you can easily index the data of any type, such as logs, metrics, and traces, and then you can use visualization interface using the OpenSearch dashboard or even the API to perform aggregation on top of those data. Next, we also have set of plugins that OpenSearch provides, which adds the comprehensive functionality such as generating alerts on the log data or look for anomalies using machine learning algorithm, or maybe use the trace analytics on and the observability feature to capture logs, metrics, and takes and traces, and then make the correlation across those logs, metrics, and traces. So let's jump on next and see why do we need data stream. So one of the common use case with OpenSearch is to index continue generating time series data such as logs, metrics, and traces. Previously, automating index rollover means you had to first create a write index, configure a rollover alias, and verify that indexes are being rolled over as expected. That makes your bootstrapping process for an index to be more cumbersome than it needs to be. So with the data stream, it is optimized for time series data that is primarily append-only in nature and simplifies all the initial setup process for the data. So let's see how the flow works with and without data stream. So prior to data stream, this is how users set up their indexes for time series data. So they start with setting up an index by specifying the index mapping and settings. And as their data grows, they encounter the scaling issue with their logs and data. And at that time, they start thinking about creating daily rotating indices on the basis of dates, or maybe use the rollover API to create an index for each day. At this point, user has got more than one indices to run the search, so they can either use the wildcard to specify the index, such as log-nginx-star, or maybe they can use the create an alias by creating the alias for those time series indices. So here in the next one, you can see they can define the index alias for all relevant index to bring it under one umbrella. And here searches can be performed across all the underlying indices on the alias. But how about performing the write operation or indexing the data? As in, how do we determine that which index would be getting the write request, right? So in this case, they can solve it by marking the latest index as the write index. And this can be solved by bringing the common settings such as the mapping, index settings, index patterns into an index template, which can be again configured on all new indices getting created as part of the rollover process. So now user needs to call the rollover, and calling it manually on daily basis is not a practical solution, and they have to manage it by themselves. So in that case, they could use the index state management policy to define the index pattern and rollover policy to rollover the indices. It could be done either on the basis of time or the size. With this legacy method, user has to be aware of so many concepts to manage and maintain those indices, and they need to set up them explicitly. So if we consolidate it, so we can see that what are the typical challenges with the time series indices. So OpenSearch has basic support of time series data, where one can name indices on the basis of timestamp by prefixing it with some name and then suffix as time, where you can have some indices on the basis of day, week, month, etc. If everything is working fine, then why do we really need data stream? So So managing your time series indices, you need to perform index rotation. Then your log ingestion tools such as Beats, Logstash can help you to rotate those indices on dates. But what if you hit onto some event such as Black Friday or Cyber Monday, where your data is significantly larger than the usual? It creates the data skew for those days where you are getting a large amount of traffic. So once index is rotated, you need to make sure that the right index is pointed to the current date index, and then index alias is rollover as well. So here, alias is nothing but a way to query all the latest data which points to the current or latest underlying index for the specific log. This is why we have the data stream come into the existence. So let's see how data stream works at very high level and solve some of these problems, being a first-class agent to store the time series data. So data stream has one or more auto-generated backing indices and prefixed by .ds, then the data stream name and the generation ID. So if you look here, the data stream name is .ds log-nginx, then the backing indices are like .ds-log-nginx-00001, then 02 and 03 and so on. Now coming back to the write operation. So for any write operation, you send the request to data stream, then it will send it to the latest index. Once an index is rolled, it will become read only and you cannot add any new document to the rotated index. So typically in the log analytics scenario, there is rarely a modification. And if needed, you can run update by query or delete by query in the older backing indices. Now let's talk about the search, like how do we perform the read request from those indices. While running the search query, data stream routes requests to all the backing indices. And of course, you can filter out the data by timestamp to perform the intelligent search on those data sets. You can also use the queries such as the aggregation query, or maybe use the filters like the Boolean filter, merge clause, sort clause, etc. to filter out the data. So this is how read and write works with the data stream. So let's talk about some of the data stream caveats what we have. So because as I mentioned, data stream is primarily designed for the append-only data. So in order to create a data stream, you first need to create an index template, which configures a set of indices as a data stream. Then you need to ensure that each document has a timestamp field, otherwise it will be added by default. Then recent data is more relevant, which makes it suitable for even the hot warm architecture with respect to the Amazon OpenSearch service. Then there are certain operations which you cannot perform that are termed as the blocked operation, like clone, delete, close, freeze. So those kind of things could not be performed because these operations could hinder the indexing, and that's why they are blocked. Talking about the ingestion API, so you can run the simple API or you can do the bulk API. But the only thing is, if you're running the bulk API, you have to explicitly specify the op type as create. That is the prerequisite for sending any bulk request using the data stream. So let's jump into the workings of data stream and see it in action with a short demo. Okay, so let's see how it works in real world. So I have logged into the OpenSearch dashboard, and I'm going to create a data stream, but as of now, I do not have any index template. And if you create a data stream without creating an index template, it will error out. So if you recall my data stream caveat slides, so in order to create it, you need to create an index template, which configures a set of indices as a data stream. And data stream object indicates that it's a data stream and not a regular index template. And then the index pattern matches with the name of the data stream over here. So in this case, if I'm going to create a data stream, it is giving me an error like no matching index template found for this particular data stream. So now I'm going to create the index template by specifying the index pattern as log-nginx. Then I have the number of shards as h1 and number of replica as h1. Then I have the timestamp field as @timestamp. Now I have created an index template. Let's verify whether I have the correct index template or not. So on running the get index template logs-nginx, you can see the index template details like the index patterns, name, number of shards, replica, what we have configured. So let's move on and then create the data stream now. So in this, basically when you create the data stream, So you can use the data stream API to explicitly create it, or even like data stream will initialize as soon as you send the first document to the index, which is matching the index pattern name. So here I'm creating the data stream explicitly by running this command, and it gives me the acknowledge true, that means data stream has been created. You can verify the data stream and associated index by running the get data stream log-nginx. In this case, it returns me the name of the data stream, the timestamp field, and what is the backing indices for this particular data stream, and then what is the generation, what is the status, and the template behind this particular data stream. Now let's start into sending or writing the data into the data stream. So here, in order to ingest data into data stream, you can use the regular indexing API. For example, over here, I'm writing the post log-nginx, which is my data stream name. Then I have a body where I have a couple of fields like message and array timestamp. So as I mentioned earlier, you need to have the timestamp field, otherwise it will give me an error. So after you run this particular command, your data is being indexed and your document has been created onto the data stream with the backing indices as ts-logs-nginx-00001. Apart from sending the individual request, you can also send the bulk API request as well in order to ingest data into the data stream. The only thing is you need to have the operation type as create when you are sending any bulk request. Now if I run this command, it inserts two documents where I have these two documents into my bulk API as well, one with the message login success and another one as the message login fail. Let's see how the search works and how you can perform searching the data stream and get all the documents from that stream. So you can do a simple search request like get your data stream name followed by the underscore search API. It will return you all the data for that particular data stream. So I have inserted three documents on it. So you can see one is with login attempt, one is the login success, and another one is the login fail. So this way you can search the data from the data stream, and you can further use the query DSL as well to run advanced queries such as the bool query with filters, running aggregations and whatnot using the data stream. Next, talk about how you can perform the rollover onto the data stream. So you can use the ISM policy in order to define the rollover policy on the basis of size or maybe on the basis of the date time. Apart from that, you can also run the manual command to rollover the data stream by running the command as post API with your data stream name followed by underscore rollover. Once you run this command, it will give you the details about your old index and the new index. So now your old index has gone into the read-only mode. You cannot perform any write operation on this, and all of the data what you are going to send, it will be sent to the new index, which is the ds-logs-nginx-00002. You can verify the rollover operation as well by running the get data stream log-nginx. And here we have the generation 2, means it has been rolled over. This is the second generation of the data stream. And then it has the details of your timestamp field and then all the indices. Next, we can talk about whether we can delete the right index or not. So if you run the command to delete the right index, which is the 02 as of now, it will error out because you cannot perform the right delete operation on the right index. So if you have to delete the right index, then you have to delete the index template and then you have to delete the data stream. So before showing you the delete command, let me quickly go to the index management page, and there we can search for all the indices what we have. So go to the indices tab, show the data stream indices, then you can select the data stream. So here I have two indices on the data stream log-nginx-00001 and 02. And you can see I have three documents on the 01 and there is no documents on 02 because we haven't run any ingestion API to index the data after the rollover. Now let's move to the command again and how you can perform the delete. So now if you go and try to delete the data stream, it will delete everything. And when you have, if you go to fetch the data stream over here, like perform any search, So it will say like no index was found because we have deleted the data stream. So once you delete the data stream, it will delete all the indices or all the backing indices as well as the write indices from that particular data stream. So this is all about a quick demo about the data stream, and let's get back onto the deck and then we can talk about what we discussed as part of the demo. So I will show all the script over there in the form of deck, and followed by a couple of documents like how you can get started with the data stream and then what should be the next step or the next action on that. Thank you. So in the demo, we have seen how you could create a data stream without creating an index template. It will error out. So if you recall the data stream caveats, in order to create a data stream, you first need to create an index template. And this is like how you can create the index template. You can refer this script for creating the index template. Once we have created the index template, you can verify those by running the get API to make sure your index template is created. Then after you have created an index template, you can create a data stream where you can use the data stream API to explicitly create a data stream. If you're not creating it explicitly, then as soon as you send the first document, it will create the data stream. Talking about the ingestion, you can send the individual request as this one, or you can refer the demo, which I showed just now, where you can send the bulk request as well with the op type as create. Then last but not the least, you can run the search request using the get data stream name /_search. It will give you the top 20 documents for that particular data stream. And then you can further use the query DSL to run advanced queries such as using the bool query with filters, running aggregations and whatnot. Lastly, we saw in the demo how you can manage those indices and data stream from OpenSearch dashboard, where you can go to the index management, filter the data for the data streams, and then it will list down all the backing indices for a particular data stream. So that's what we covered as part of a demo. So coming back to the conclusion, so in a nutshell, data stream helps you to intelligently manage the time series data, where developer or operation team can perform focus on the development and growing their business, rather than spending time on management tasks such as managing time series indices, performing the rollover, and so on. So this concludes a quick overview of data stream along with a demo. If you would like to know more about data stream, please check out our documentation, which you can get from the QR code as shown here. So thank you for listening, and feel free to reach out to us if you have any further questions. Thank you.